So in this video, we are going to learn how we can make the T-Rex game app in Scratch. Let's play this one. So as I scored 500, I got the alarm, right? So similarly, at every multiple of 500, I will get this tune. I will get this sound. Okay, so this is the basic T-Rex game. For that app which is being showed in that trailer, so it's a project. So I have divided and fragmented the project into various sections. So the very first section, we are going to develop the basic T-Rex game. In the second one, we will have an introduction screen which you have seen in the trailer with some instructions, and we will also add the start button over there. So when you click on that button, your game is going to start. And then we can also have a video on like how we can change the display of the score which is there instead of that basic default score display which is provided by Scratch. You can have a digitized, a different look for that score. So we can have video on that as well. Then the next is going to be creating your app out of your Scratch game project. So this app you can share with any of your friends or relatives or your parents, whomsoever you want to share it with, and it can run on any smartphone, tablets or PCs. So let's get started with the very first one, creating that basic T-Rex file. So I don't need this cat. I'm going to delete this. And the backdrop, I'm going to take a sky blue one, the plain backdrop. I want a scrolling background. So I'm going to paint it. I'll take the line tool. Just take the width of 5. So let's draw the line from here to here. Right? Now it's a straight line. Now click on this tool, the reshape tool, and then you just, why I'm doing it, so that I can create some bumps on my road, right? Just like we have in our T-Rex game. Now I'm going to zoom in so that I can clearly see my points, and then I'm going to lift them up a little bit like this. So let's do it. Once it is done, just select it and bring it down using the scroll key or the arrow keys. We want this road or this line to scroll across my state. So for that, I have to code. First of all, let's see, when the flag is clicked, I want that the position of X should be fixed. And then from here it should move towards the left. So when your value, when your sprite moves from the right hand side to the left hand side, the value of X is going to be negative. Move 10 steps towards the left hand side, so minus 10. So let's see, it has moved, right? But then I want the whole line, so let's repeat it for a number of times. Go to control. And let's see if I repeat it 10 times, what will happen, right? So let's increase it, or let's see what will happen. Okay. If I have a forever loop, then it will continuously going to move. Let's see that, right? It's time to add our second sprite. We will take next sprite as cloud. So it's working fine. Otherwise you can have another way also, like when the flag is clicked, and then glide to this position, right? So just take it to the very left hand side motion, glide 1 second to, I'll just change it to 150, that will be fine, right? Let's see. So this is also working. Let's check that again. So either way you can take, right? Now the clouds are not that visible. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to the costume and then I'm going to fill a different color. Let's take a little bit dark gray color and then I'm going to fill inside each one so that they are visible. Then I also will say that go to looks and change the costume. So let's see. And if you want them to go slower, you can increase the timing. So it will be perfect, right? Now once it is done, you will be having the dino over here in our game. I'm going to upload this sprite. And then here is my dino. You can see this white background. Now you can remove this white background using two ways. Either use the scratch or there is another software in Windows 10. This is Paint 3D. It will clearly remove each and every white pixel of your image. So let's quickly do it in scratch. So I'm going to the costume. And click on this one and this line, it means no fill. And when I click on it, you can see that the white area has been deleted. But if you see that little bit white area is there around the dino, it can be completely removed using the Paint 3D. Just check out the video for that, which is there in the description box. Then let's reduce the size. Let's make the cloud size as 75 and the dino size I'm just going to take as 50. Okay. And after this, let's go to motion and take the current position of the dino. Now I want that whenever I click on the flap, it should come to its position. And if I click on the, if I press a spacebar key, it should jump up and down. So how does this happen? Right? So now after that, I want this to come down. So I'm just going to duplicate this quickly. And then I'll say minus 10. Right? So let's see. When the spacebar key is pressed, it is jumping. Right? I don't want it to be too high, so let's change it to my 15 steps. Now I will create some costume for my dino so that there is some kind of animation. So I'm going to duplicate this and that's after this I'm just going to take the select tool and then I'm going to select the leg. Then I'm going to rotate it like this and just adjust it over here. Now I want this dino to change its costume. Let's go to control forever and take the next costume which is in looks. Let's see. It is too fast so you can make it wait. Go to control. Wait for 1 second will be too much slower. So you can reduce it to 0.5. I have experimented. 0.3 was perfect for me. So again, I'm going to take the cacti over here. Just like we have saved the image of the dino and we have used in our scratch, similarly, you will save the image of the cacti from Google and use them in your scratch project. So I'm going to upload the cacti. This is one of the costume. Too large. 25, I think, will be perfect. Yeah. So I'm going to place it here. I want this to start from here. Take your forever loop and go to motion, go to this, and now you want this one to glide to this position, right? So glide let it be 10 minus 105. This way it is going to move. Now if you want, you can add another cacti. So what I'll do, I'll just click on this and I'll go to costume. I'll upload another cacti, this one. One more thing, next costume. So go to looks and next costume over here. Now I'll be having both of them. Now if you want that they should come at different times, so what you can do, glide and go to operators, pick random. I just want them to appear between 1 second to 1.5 second, so let's keep it over here so that they appear at different time. Okay, so the next thing I'm going to do, that if my dino is going to touch the cacti, it's the game is going to over, right? So now let's code. When the dino is touching the cacti, the game is going to over, the game is going to stop. So I just click on the cacti and I'll say when clicked, so it has stopped. Now I just want to create a variable where it is going to increment when our game starts. So let's create the variable now. Go to variable and make score and take the forever loop. Put it over here. Okay, change score to by 1, and this is how. This is the basic game. Now the next thing is that whenever this dino is touching the cacti, it should take this costume. That when it is touching the dino, this cacti is touching the dino, it should stop everything and it should broadcast a message. Before stopping everything, it will broadcast a message. So I'll go to events, broadcast message 1, which is being received by this dino. When I receive message 1, change costume to a third costume, right? And whenever it start, it should start with the very first costume. So switch costume to the very first one, just this one. So let's see